go, boys. Let me go, boys. Let me go down in the muddy rivers, I'll run dry. This land was always ours, was the proud land of our fathers. Lost to us and then, not any of the others. Let them go, boys. Let them go, boys. Let them go down in the muddy rivers, I'll run dry.
Sing that song every once in a while because I think Shane McGowan's one of the best songwriters that ever walked the earth. And nobody can fucking understand it when he sings it. So now if I can just get more people to understand this song.
Pistol in a Tino store, Tino store. Past 13, thought it was the finest he ever had seen. That's the black and heaven, so the window blew up. Mama dropped a dozen, it's really blue, really blue, really nice. Mama says a pistol in the devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is the devil's right hand. First pistol was a cap and ball coat. Shoot his fine line, I'm with you, load of my slow. Load of my slow. Soon I find out, tin of troubles, can't do that. Then I went and got myself a Colt 45. Call a peacemaker, never knew why. Never knew why, didn't understand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, the devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Touched his hoose and never had a chance to drop. Got in the morning and told me out of bed. I smiled, played and locked it to set my guilty. I said, got there on man. Nothing but your trigger but a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right hand. Devil's right hand, the devil's right hand. Nothing touch your trigger but a devil's right hand. Mama says a pistol is a devil's right
Gary's favorite song of mine. It's for Gary Olson.
over that rainbow. I'm gonna get Heineken someday. I'm gonna get Heineken someday. 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 Got this rig unwound, I'ma come 1,000 miles from a guitar town. Nothing ever happened in my hometown. I ain't the kind of just hang around. But I heard someone calling my name one day. Tell me you can't get far. $37 in the Jap guitar. Watch. Now smoking in the Tesla with a hammer down. Rocking a little combo from a guitar town. Whoa! I got an empty feeling deep inside. my bed. I come in from Gettysburg, and I knew boys. Boy, you look like hell was all she said. Well, a month went by without a word. Somebody down to holler her about that boy that hung on. That old man to spare his life. I tried my bloody random night. He picked it up, the thought he was the one. I went down to Tennantown. I went down to Tennantown. Going back here in the mall.
Thank you very much. That's for those of you from Maryland, not D.C. Maryland, but Maryland, Maryland. I do know that it's Tiny Town. I just didn't when I wrote the fucking song. I got it off of a map. I know way too much about the Civil War, and it was just close to Gettysburg. That's all I was supposed to say. Let's see. Uh-oh, hang on. There that booger is. I like that when they surrender all the another one. Of them surrendering once. Felt like I'm in Atlanta. Watch the news tomorrow. This goes out to, what's her name? Wherever the hell she is. Her mama's only child. They didn't understand it all. She took the running wild. She left town one day and never said goodbye. Left a hole in daddy's lap and a tear in mama's eye. Where'd we go wrong? Now she's gone. She met a boy up in Kentucky. Charlie was his name. Just when he thought he got lucky, she stood and watched him change. She always kept on moving and she never wasted time. They said she left quite a string of broken hearts behind. Woke up alone, now she's kisses and I smell her perfume in the wind. If I could, you know that I would do it all again. She'd done me wrong. Now she's gone. Same girl. Different harmonica. Some girls are just better for songs than others, and I have no explanation for that whatsoever. It's like, has nothing to do with the quality of the girl, I assure you. But some, this one was particularly good.
Thank you.
is saying goodbye.
Which brings us to the chick song portion of the program. I write these songs on purpose. I've been doing it as long as I've been had a guitar, since I was about 14. And yes, I was that pain in the ass that took my guitar to every party I ever went to. And my first audiences were pretty much exclusively between 3 and 5 girls. And I knew a lot of Rolling Stone songs and Bob Dylan songs, but the truth is that Mick Jagger and Bob Dylan scared the fuck out of 14-year-old girls, so I learned a lot of Donovan songs, man. Because it worked, and it became a template for the rest of my life and career. I am not above, like, repurposing a song I wrote for one girl and using it on another girl. They are in my songs after that. And now, at this point, it prevents my audience from growing exponentially hairier and uglier as time goes on. So it's like, I've actually heard women argue about which song is about who, and I never have the heart to tell them. They're all about me. My baby's sparkling shine, sparkling shine, sparkling shine. My baby's sparkling and shine. Everyone knows she's fine. Blesses all that she sees, toss her hair and a kiss in the breeze. But she don't love no one but me. I can't believe she minds. She murmurs, she moves. Sunlight all around her, even when she is blue. Silver clouds. Sparkle and shine, sparkle and shine, sparkle and shine. My baby's sparkle and shine. Everyone knows she's fine. My baby swings down the street, big tall high heel shoes on my feet. Walks by, my heart skips a beat, stumbling like a fool. She gave me something so sweet, I can't sleep, y'all, I can't eat. Sparks fly whenever we meet, I'm breathless cause she's so cool. Anywhere she goes, sparkle and shine, sparkle and shine, sparkle and shine. My baby sparkle and shine, everyone knows she's mine. Everyone knows she's mine. Another way of arriving at precisely the same thing. Ooh,
lips and mine. Oh, smooth like silk, sweet like wine. I never had another kiss taste like that. You're the best lover that I ever had. You're the best lover that I ever had.
Anything at all, and all of a sudden you're listing irretrievably over towards the blues, and there's nothing you can do. Towns Van Zandt said, there are two kinds of music. There's the blues, and there's zippity-doo-dah. This ain't zippity-doo-dah. Just to ease my pain. Went downtown just to ease my pain. I ended up out walking in the rain. I took my pistol and a $100 bill. Took my pistol and a $100 bill. And everything I need to get me killed. Now the Southside girls, they suit me just fine.
Lakeside girls, they suit me just fine. Long as I got money, they don't whine.
That's important.
Rockin' tear far away up atop the little street, and I walk down to them. Far way up top, I walk down to them. Go way down in the bottom shop, I come back up again. Papa too, they both talk till they turn blue. I got them bulls out Nashville blues again. Can't be satisfied until they wipe me up again.
Thank you very much. Now, that's a pretty good song. I'm proud of that song. I sing it all over the world for some time now. But I realized almost instantly when I made it up that it contained a nearly fatal flaw. And that is, it has a tendency to make that particular part of my life sound like a lot more fucking fun than it really was. Especially the bit right at the end there. And so what I do, and what I've done, for the last, 28 years as of last September, which means damn near 29 years, suggests really strongly that whenever I sing that song, I probably should sing this song, Lest I Forget. So, welcome to my nightmare. Kill my pain. Cocaine cannot kill my pain. Cocaine cannot kill my pain. Like a freight train to my pain. Cocaine cannot kill my pain. Whiskey got no hold on me. Whiskey got no hold on me. Whiskey got no hold on me, left in chains in Tennessee. Whiskey got no hold on me. Don't come knocking on my door. Don't come knocking on my door. Girl, don't come knocking on my door. And even that won't hurt no more. Don't come knocking on my door. This hell was the only thing. Hell was the only thing. The Dodd and Springs, and it was the only thing. Oh,
leave me alone. Guess you best leave me alone. I guess you best leave me alone, at least until these blues are gone. Guess you best leave me alone. Cause cocaine cannot kill my pain. Kill my pain. Cocaine cannot kill my pain, like a freight train through my pain. Cocaine cannot kill my pain. Thank you. rules are still signed. Backers never carry you where you want them to. Leave you standing there with limbo transcendental blue.
Down to it, what a big ass 12 string guitar is really all about is this hymn. Hey. Everybody calling, ain't you seen a stranger to the devil? I know. His markers on her body and fiber in her soul. And when we're making love, he's laughing at us down below. She's the devil I know, devil I know. She's the devil I know. Say I come from heaven, but angel is the devil I know. She's the devil I know. She's the kind of woman that'll keep her coming back for more. Got the kind of face you swear you've seen someplace before. Could have been your mama and could have been a Mexican hoe. She's the devil I know, devil I know. She's the devil I know. Says I come to heaven, but her angel is the devil I know. She's the devil. Yeah, yeah.
Do nothing, I just like doing that.
She dragged me straight to hell, I can tell, and I think I'll just go. Yeah, the devil said here to deliver my body and soul. Every inch strapped and down, I'm closer to the glow. She's the devil. Yeah, she's the devil I know. She's the devil I know. She's a come heaven, but her angel is the devil I know. She's, yeah, she's the devil I know. She's the devil I know. She's a come heaven, but her angel is the devil I know. She's the devil I know. Hey.
Sure, glad that by the time I get out here playing, nobody's eating anything, because this is an unsanitary instrument.
Thank you.
tonight. Yeah, I feel alright. I feel alright tonight. I bring you precious contemplation, tales from distant land. Conquerors and concubines, conjurers from darker town. Tuneland, conspiracy, sacrilege, and heresy. Oh, but I feel alright. I feel alright tonight. Yeah, I feel alright. I feel alright tonight. Criticize, sympathize. Just be careful what you wish for, friend. I've been to hell, now I'm back again. I feel alright. I feel alright tonight. Yeah, I feel alright. I feel alright tonight.
You guys know probably by now, I've been coming here since my first record came out, and first night I ever played DC, I played the 9:30 one night, the old 9:30, and the old Birchmere the next night. My MO has always been to like write a record and then record it and then go out to tour to support it, and that didn't happen in 2019 and 2020. I wrote a record and I recorded it, but nobody went fucking anywhere. That record was really important to me, and I wanted people to hear it because most of the songs were written for a play called Coal Country, which myself, Jessica Blank, and Eric Jensen, thank you, we were commissioned by the Public Theater in New York City to travel to West Virginia and get to know the folks who were the survivors. That means some guys that were there that day, mostly family members of people that didn't make it, but the worst mining disaster in this country since the 1970s in a mine called Upper Big Branch. Now, Upper Big Branch was the first non-union mine on that mountain. And it's not an accident or a coincidence that it's blue. That is precisely what trade unions do, is they protect workers. And for me, it was also a chance to address something and start a conversation I think is important, because my politics have not changed. I'm a radical motherfucker. I belong to three unions until two of them merged. And but I do believe we've reached a point in this country where we don't listen to each other anymore. And so the idea of presenting, you know, a show about people from West Virginia and New York City intrigued me, and vice versa, that people in West Virginia got to find out about people in New York. For instance, if you ask somebody in New York what West Virginia is and what it's like, they would probably say, oh, that's a red state, that's a Trump state. That's not true. It's a purple state at best. Yeah. They got a Democratic senator. He's an asshole, but they got him. What it is a coal state. It's a coal state. And that freaks friends of mine out to think like I do. I am worried about the environment, and I think all that bad stuff, black stuff, is bad for the air. But as long as people are going underground to get it and we're still using it, those guys deserve to be protected. It's that simple. So right there is something New York and
West Virginia had in common that none of them imagined, that was the whole concept of trade unions, which I think we're reaching a point in our history where we're looking at that again, and we're going to find out if you are, you got a boss, you probably need a union. If you were up really early on the morning of April 6th, 2010, I mean, really early. It was national news for about 30 seconds, the explosion at Upper Big Branch. And you're just seeing all the networks out there, cable channels, talking to anybody that would talk to them. One gentleman you would have heard from is a gentleman called Tommy Davis. Because Tommy was there that day. He just got up top when it blew. But in that instant, Tommy lost his firstborn son, his big brother, and his nephew. So Tommy was talking, because Tommy was angry. Tommy wanted answers. Look me in the eyes when you're talking to me. Wanna see in your soul when you lie. Don't try and tell me that you couldn't foresee. Well, everybody reckons it's a matter of time. Goddamn right, I'm emotional. I ain't nothing but a man. Hell yes, this is personal. Before you leave here, gonna understand. It's about father. It's about son. It's about lovers with love in the middle of a line alone. It's about muscle. It's about bone. It's about a river running thicker than water. And it's about blood. Upon a time in America, working man knew where he stood, and nowadays just getting by is a miracle. Probably couldn't give it up if I would. Try and tell me about the state of the economy, fiscal reality, profit and loss. None of that matters when you're underground anyway. Damn, she can't tell me nothing about cost. It's about fathers, it's about sons, it's about lovers waking up in the middle of a night alone. It's about muscle, it's about bone, it's about a river running thicker than water, and it's about blood. Tell yourself it was an accident, isolated incident, part of the job. Yeah, well, tell that to the families, kids without dad isn't tell it to God. Set the wind you hear howling through the holler. Or the ghost of a willy cry. For every man that died for a cold coming dollar, a lung full of dust and a heart full of lies. It's about fathers, it's about sons, it's about lovers we love in the middle of a night alone. It's about muscle, it's about bone, it's about a river running thicker than water, and it's about blood. Acord, Jason Atkins, Chris Bell, Greg Brock, Kenny Chapman, Robert E. Clark, Jimmy Davis, Corey Davis, Michael Lee Ellswick, William L. Griffith, Stephen Hara, Dean Jones, Richard K. Lane, William Roosevelt Lynch, Nicholas Darrell McCroskey, Joe Markham, Ronald Lee Maynor, Eddie Mooney, Adam Morgan, Rex Mullins, Joshua Knapper, Boone Payne, Dewey Persinger, Jody Price, Stuart Scott, Mary Wayne Carl, Overdale Skeens, Benny Willingham, Ricky Workman. It's about blood.
Thank you.
got interrupted, and I made that record and put it out in 2020, and it was like almost nobody heard it. We got them back there. You should check it out. And then I made two more records of songs that I didn't write. And that last one was, I've only made four of those in my life out of 22. The first one was a record of Townsend's Aunt songs that I made a couple of decades back. And then Guy Clark passed away. I made a record of Guy's songs. I can see him standing right here. And then, while we were all locked down, we lost Jerry Jeff Walker. And that was it. That was the last of my original three teachers. So, we couldn't do anything at first, but as soon as we could travel and get together again, I was honored to be asked to come to Austin and sing My Old Man at Jerry Jeff's graveside in the Texas State Cemetery. And then myself, Emmylou Harris, Jimmy Buffett, Keith Sykes, Ramblin' Jack Elliott, Jeff Hanna, Pat Green, Django Walker. We all went out to Luckenbach and we sang Jerry Jeff Walker songs all night long. And I took that opportunity to get Susan and Django and Jesse's blessing. And I started to work on a record. I didn't have to learn very many of these songs. This particular song I've been singing longer than almost anything else. Going back to when I was 14, because I learned it for a play that I did during my short career in high school. And I sang this song in that play, and I became famous for this song in my high school. And I played it every time I unpacked a guitar. Until I was 19, and I met Jerry Jeff Walker, and I had to kind of quit singing it. My favorite thing about this project is that I get to sing this song again. And you know what? You can sing it too. And I bet you know it. New man Bojangles and dance for you. Worn out shoes, silver hair, ragged shirt, and bag of pants. The old soft shoe, it jumps so high, it jumps so high. It'll lightly touch down. Met a man who said in New Orleans I was down and out. Looked to me to be the very eyes of age, and spoke right out. He talked a lot and talked a lot. Laugh and slap his leg a step. Said the name Bojangles and it danced a leg across the cell. Grabbed the pants for a better stance than to jump so high. Then he clicked his heels. Let go laugh, let go laugh. Shook his clothes back all around. Here we go. Mr. Bojangles. He can't hear you. Mr. Bojangles.
Mr. Bojangles shows and county fairs throughout the South. Talks and tears of 15 years out diving in. Traveled and battled. Dog up and down, up and down. For 20 years he still grieves. Said not dance at every chance in the honky-tonks for drinks and tips. Most of my time I spend behind these county bars. I drinks a bit. Shook his head, and as he shook his head, heard someone ask him, please, please,
Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles.
And then there was the record I couldn't imagine making in a million years. This past Sunday, we lost a great singer-songwriter. And I lost my firstborn son, who I love more than anything else in this world. Now, that is a hole that I get to walk around for the rest of my life. There's not anything anybody can do to spare me that. Ram Dass said, specifically about losing a child, that my pain is his legacy. And I understand that. That makes sense to me more than anything else anybody said to me. So you'll hear people say the one thing you're not supposed to ever have to do is bury a child. And the truth is that kind of doesn't ring true to me. Somebody has to do it every day. Somebody's doing it right now. And so it didn't help me very much. The only good I can find in it is to be able to stand up here and say this. Justin died of an overdose of fentanyl. Now, he did not use opiates. It was in an 8-ball of cocaine that he bought. Now, I'm somewhat of an expert on these things. I know what an 8-ball of cocaine looks like, and I know what was there. He had the better part of an 8-ball in his pocket. There were 3 lines still on the table, and he made about a step towards the bathroom, and he fell on the floor. So that means, and this is the important part of this rant, is he went down on the first bump. So what you can do for me is just to hear me when I say this. It is out there. It is dangerous. It's in fucking everything. It's in meth. It's in pot sometimes now. It's in coke. And it's incredibly dangerous, so be careful. And help me sing this song. Know you could sing. I got to know Pete Seeger a lot better during the last decade of his life because I was in New York, and I was paying attention because I took notes for a point of my career that's coming down the road because I'm never going to stop doing this. And was weak some nights, but he could get the audience to sing the whole fucking show for him, so I was paying attention. And I had the honor of presenting Pete's lifetime union card to him at the Musicians Union Gala, and he was 92. And I gave it to him, and all I said, "Hey, Pete, I think this means you don't have to pay dues anymore." And he thought that was hilarious. So he joined that union when he was 18 years old. So let's see. Let's go to church. Thank you. took a stroll around the old long walk of the day. I met a little girl, stopped to talk of a fine salt day. Ask a friend, what's a fella to do? Ooh, her hair's black and her eyes are blue. Behind me right then, I'll be taking the world around the salt to a prom with a Galway girl.
trash curse around here in Hawaii. Down to the Tuzzle Duty and be head man. I come home with a brand new plan. I take seat from Colombia and Mexico. Plan out a hollow down copper in blue. Got a chopper in the air. Wake up screaming, I'm back over there. Line up, take a tea, the child on the door. Better stay away from Copperhead Road.
There's a strike going on, you know, the writers that write all of the stories that you see on television have been on strike for a while. And my union, I aspire to being in that union. I started dabbling in that myself, but my union, SAG-AFTRA, followed the WGA out. And that seems like it isn't important, but basically what's happening to that industry is what happened to the music business about 10 years ago, and it affected my life a lot. I barely could afford to pay my alimony anymore. I had to work all the time, so the mailbox money went away in what I do. And the truth is, art is important, and it needs to be supported, and we only do it through corporations in this country. So, you know, they'll talk about the difference between animals and human beings being an opposable thumb. That's fucking stupid. If there is a difference, it's that we make and we consume art, and we've never proven that animals don't do that. Art's really important. It's not. It's taught as elective in our schools, and that's the first place that we fucked up in this culture. So, these guys deserve our support, and then we get more great stories. The best writing being done today, absolutely the best fiction being written is being written for television. And I think that's, you know why? Because the writers fucking run it. That's what that's all about. So this, I learned, I'd never been anywhere near being an actor. I turned down a lot of roles when I was younger and skittier. And I hated it when at that point in my life, I hated it when actors made records, you know, so it was one of those things. And then David Simon, who's here tonight, decided that I was gonna, he liked to hire people that weren't really actors, and he wanted me to come, and I didn't have to act, I wasn't scary, I was playing a redneck recovering addict, so all I had to do was show up. And I learned more about writing and that, you know, little bit of a couple of seasons of The Wire, and a season and a half of Treme up until they shot me in the face. So this goes out to David, and I got to sing this Tom Waits song. When you walk through the garden, you better watch your back. I beg your pardon, walk this narrow track. If you walk with Jesus, it's gonna save your soul. Gotta keep the devil way down in the hole. He's got the fire and the fury at his command, and you don't have to worry if you hold on to Jesus' hand. You're not heed temptation when the thunder rolls. Gotta keep a devil way down in the hole. Jesus' mighty soul, seven with the wings, keep you close to the Lord. His thigh seven ten, cause his hands are so cold. Well, you gotta keep the devil way down in the hole. This is your part. In the hole, 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 in the hole. Is David called me and he said, you know, to see if I would be available to be in one episode at the end of season four and more episodes in five. And he called me at a good time because I was unemployed. I didn't have a record deal. And I just moved to New York. And then he said, well, yes, because five's going to be the last season. And I said, cool. And I hung up. And I was getting ready to call my manager. And then I said, wait a minute. Did he say the last season? And I called him back. I said, fuck it, on one condition, I want to do the Waits song, because it was a different artist every year, so that was like, I immediately called him back, and he, you know, I got to do the Tom Waits song, so. And by the way, Tom Waits told me that was, mine was his favorite cover of all those covers. So let's see, Hardcore Troubadour Radio on Saturday nights and Sunday. Had kind of a big bluegrass show this last week. Gary would have been proud. And, what else is going on? I'll be out doing this again next summer. I pretty much tour in the summertime so I can keep John Henry in school in New York where he needs to be. And he goes to his mom in the summer, and I get on the bus. And that's when you'll be seeing me. And I am I haven't quit writing songs. What I'm doing is I'm working on a musical. Now, I've done a couple of plays with music. That's what I moved to theater for. And did a Richard Maxwell play, and then did Coal Country with Jessica and Eric at the Public Theater. But this is different. This is a real musical. Daisy Foote, whose father was Horton Foote, and I are writing a musical of Tender Mercies. And if great film that her father wrote the screenplay for. He was a playwright, is what he did. Most of them, he wrote The Trip to Bountiful. And but that script was his, and we've been working on it for a couple of years, and theater takes a long time. So you will hear those songs eventually. I think we're gonna put out a few tracks here and there of stuff that I write that doesn't have anything to do with the musical, because I really can't make the musical and make an album at the same time. It's just too much, especially for a single dad. So. And what else? Let's see. Oh, yeah. What I said earlier, two things. One is, we're coming up on an election. This was those time of year when everybody else started telling that people vote their pocketbooks. That's not true. Rich people vote their pocketbooks. Yeah. Working people vote their hearts. They vote their families and their livelihoods. And it's important to remember that. Brings us to not being so judgmental and try to understand if somebody didn't vote the way that you did. And then we got a chance at getting everybody into a situation where we can get this to work. We stopped listening to each other. And, look, if you can't have a conversation with somebody that you see them and you're, you know, we make judgments really fast. Somebody that, I'm a radical motherfucker. People look at me and go, oh, shit. But if you can't have a conversation with somebody you know you're going to disagree with at the beginning of the conversation, democracy's not possible. So let's try to listen a little bit better, and y'all be careful. Huh? Out there hollering, darling, don't you love me more? But you always let a man before, didn't you? He's singing a sable song they always sang before. He's the last of high-court troubadours. Hey, girl, better figure out which you wish. Out there on you, you son of a bitch. Just a survivor switch, what you make love on your satin sheets, wake up on the living room floor. He'll last till I coach you the door. He's lasting on my direct. Baby, what are you waiting for? Hey, girl, figure out what you want to do. Move on again, and he leaves you alone and blue. But you knew it just passing through, didn't you? Just say this is the last time, baby, like you always did before. Be the last of the high court you below. Be the last thing you're not to right. Stand beneath your window to daylight. He is the last of the high court you below. Baby, why you waiting for? He is the last thing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Hamper Danny Burns as well.